Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1842. Jordan Goldmeier, happy holidays. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This week I got a great holiday card from Excel MVP Jordan Goldmeier. You might remember Jordan. He was on the podcast about a month ago with his great rollover trick. I said, Jordan, this is so cool. Do you mind if I share it on the podcast? So we're going to come out here to this URL. You're going to look right down there in the YouTube description to get that URL. Click download file. I'll download real quick. Now, before you open this in Excel, if you've never used macros before, you're going to do Alt-T-M-S. And make sure your macro settings are disabled with notification, the second one, not the first one. If you have the first one, you won't be able to use this. And then open the file in Excel. All right, a couple of things. Make sure that you enable editing, and then finally enable macros. Now here, this is really cool. Jordan has created a holiday card where we can click Let It Snow, and the snow starts to fall. And so you can sit there and you know, just watch this instead of the fireplace that the cable show shows tomorrow. You can watch the snow start to accumulate, and then quit snowing and finally plow snow. Now, this is cool to watch, right? But of course, for those of you into VBA, the one of the nice things is that Jordan has unprotected all the code. The worksheet is protected, but you can unprotect it and see what's going on. And so, first thing, it's clever. The snowflakes are actually 150 different objects, and I'm typing the number one here. You see that Jordan has had conditional formatting that if you put the number one, you get a red cell. So he's able to use conditional formatting to display the message. In fact, you can probably come in here and change the zeros and the ones and change the message to something else, provided you stay within this range here, or change the range to be something larger. But I thought what was fascinating, let's go back to Alt F11, take a look at the code. A couple of things I picked up here from Jordan. First thing, he created a new type called snowflake that has three properties: current row, current column, and the color. If you'll notice, there's four possible colors that appear. The white is the most common, but there's also kind of two shades of blue that show up. So we have those properties, three properties for each snowflake, and then does a snow array using that type of snowflake. Later on, redims that to have 150 different items. So now we have 150 items, and Jordan is, rather than checking every cell in the range, which is probably what I would have done, just has to check the 150 items, see where they are. He has it randomly fall anywhere from 1 to 10 cells. So where's the random times 10? And then checks to see what's going on in that cell. So that's why sometimes you'll see that there are snowflakes that will make it through, like in this range right here, because if the snowflake is currently here, it might randomly fall there, it might randomly fall there, randomly fall here, and then make it through the L. But if you have something really, really long here, it's never going to make it through that. So these cells will never get filled in. You know, so kind of interesting the algorithm that Jordan has. I wrote back to Jordan. You know, this is typical. You know, at the MVP summit, the Excel team shows us something really cool, and then we all pile on with new feature requests. I'm like, Jordan, you should add a button here that says west wind, right? That would allow the snowflakes to start to move to the right, and then potentially you could get some, depending on how strong the wind was, I guess, you could get some things happening there. Let's go back to the code, Alt F11, and you know, actually, I realized by changing the current column here, right now he's just doing rand. If we did that random times 3 or random times 10, you could actually get some wind going in there. So take a look at the code if you're interested in VBA. You know, to plow snow, all he has to do is set the original color back to 1. So each snowflake is a different color index, and of course in the conditional formatting, no matter what color you choose, the conditional formatting wins. And it was actually kind of interesting, once you unprotect and you select these and have it start snowing, you'll be able to see kind of that some snowflakes actually fall into the red and then get stuck. So it's fascinating to watch, but if you're into VBA, it's good to go take a look and see the tricks that Jordan used. So check that out. Again, the link is right down there in the YouTube description, and you can download the file. So thanks to Jordan for that. Happy holidays to everyone who's watching. Thanks again to Jordan for that sharing that great file. And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.